Pour dish soap into an ice cube tray and place it in the freezer. It will gain new properties. Most people use dishwashing liquid every day, unaware that a simple action can enhance its effectiveness. Instead of pouring the entire amount into the dispenser, leave some liquid and pour it into a regular ice cube tray. Fill it halfway. The liquid will expand during freezing. Place the prepared tray in the freezer overnight. In the morning, the liquid should be fully frozen. Let us know in the comments which city you're watching us from. In this form, it will have new properties. It will be useful for special tasks, such as a burnt oven or grill grate. Cleaning them can be irritating. With these cubes, you'll do it much faster. Simply take one out and start sliding it over the grate. The liquid will spread, removing stains and burnt grease. Toss such cubes into the sink when an unpleasant odor emanates from it. The problem will disappear instantly. The liquid will slowly thaw and flow through the pipes, cleaning them during everyday sink use. Were you familiar with the trick of freezing dish soap? I always keep a few cubes in the freezer. I clean the washing machine regularly. Dirt and limescale disappear. The washing machine is clean, and the laundry always smells fresh. Apply toothpaste to the inner glass of the door. Take half a lemon and spread the paste. Do this especially at the edges, where residue from water and detergents often accumulates. Once you've cleaned the entire glass, toss the lemon into the washing machine drum. Now, focus on the door seal in the washing machine. This is the area where most dirt accumulates and mold. Sprinkle this area with baking soda. It will remove dirt, mold spores, and eliminate unpleasant odors. After doing this, close the washing machine. Open the detergent drawer and spray it with vinegar, all compartments. Vinegar removes limescale, detergent, residue, and mold. If you clean the washing machine irregularly, mold will never appear. Close the drawer and run the washing machine on a standard program. Toothpaste, lemon, baking soda, and vinegar will clean the interior of the washing machine and eliminate deposits and limescale. These ingredients also eliminate mold spores, which may be responsible for the unpleasant odor coming from the washing machine. When the washing machine finishes, open it and remove the lemon. You'll immediately notice that the entire interior shines. Wipe it dry, and it will be cleaner than ever. The detergent drawer will also be cleaner. During the next laundry cycle, you'll notice that your clothes will smell wonderfully. You don't have to worry about the smell of mustiness and mold. Behind the oven door, there is a hidden button that makes cleaning easier. Most people are unaware of it. Just pull it upwards to release the lock. Repeat the process on the other side. With the doors prepared in this way, they will be easy to remove. Next, grab them and lift them slightly. The hinges should come out on their own. There is a protective plastic on the oven door. Use a screwdriver to pry it open and then remove it. This way, you'll be able to disassemble and clean the glass. Not everyone knows that you can also remove the rack and glass when cleaning. Just pull them towards you with a firm motion. This way, you can thoroughly clean the oven walls. If you don't like scrubbing off burnt grease and food residues, use baking soda. It has excellent cleaning properties and is safe for health. Sprinkle it evenly over the doors and inside the oven using a sieve. A thick layer should cover the entire surface. Then, take a paper towel. Spread it in the areas covered with baking soda. Pour a cup of vinegar into a spray bottle. Screw it tightly. Spray the towels generously with it. They should absorb the mixture well. Both substances will react under the towels and start removing burnt food. Leave it all for 15 minutes. After that time, simply remove the towels and wipe the oven with them. All the dirt will stick to their surface, and you won't have to scrub. It can even handle tough stains.
Today, I will show you a clever way to clean laminate and wooden floors. I make the cleaning balls myself at home. All you need to do is put two balls in a bucket and mop the floor. All the stains disappear, and there are no streaks left behind. Making these balls costs just a few cents, and they work better than regular floor cleaners. To prepare them, you will need 500 grams of baking soda. Add 2 tablespoons of denatured alcohol to it. Denatured alcohol has degreasing and disinfecting properties. It effectively removes scuff marks from shoes and paint stains. Next, add a measure of your favorite fabric softener. This ingredient not only adds a pleasant scent, but also has anti-static properties. This prevents dust from settling on the floor. Put on rubber gloves and mix everything together. Knead it thoroughly. If the mixture is too loose, add some laundry detergent. With your hands, shape the mixture into golf ball-sized balls. Then place the balls on a plastic board and let them dry overnight. The next day, gently transfer them into a container. This way, you can store them for a few weeks. Soda balls have cleansing, antibacterial, and antifungal properties. The denatured alcohol prevents streaking. In a bucket of warm water, put 2 balls. This amount is enough to clean the floors in the entire house. The soda reacts with water, creating a cleaning foam. The cleaning agents quickly dissolve in the bucket, allowing the mop to evenly absorb them. Then, mop the floor. A pleasant fragrance fills the apartment immediately. It dries quickly and leaves no streaks. If you like this recipe, give it a thumbs up.
I mixed acetone with coffee and surprised everyone with the result. You will be amazed by this product too. It's different from all the ones you've seen and used so far. To make this trick work, put 4 tablespoons of coffee in a bowl. Add about 100 milliliters of water and mix. The next ingredient you need for this trick is acetone. It is a product most commonly used to remove and dissolve many organic substances. Just 2 tablespoons of acetone are enough to remove various stains, dissolve burnt fats, and effortlessly eliminate different spots. The final ingredient in the mixture is dishwashing liquid. Use 4 tablespoons and mix everything well. Dishwashing liquid handles various kitchen stains perfectly. But in combination with coffee and acetone, it becomes even more effective. When all the ingredients come together, pour the prepared mixture into a spray bottle. This way, you can use it best and take advantage of its properties. The ingredients in this mixture, once combined and mixed, are ready for immediate use. Such a small amount is already sufficient to clean many pots and pans, or one pan, many times. Let me know if you also use coffee for cleaning in your home. This mixture will help you get rid of dirt and burnt residues from pans without scrubbing. You will be surprised at how quickly it dissolves grease layers compared to many other products designed for this purpose. It's different from all the ones you've used so far to remove stains and burnt residues. Just apply this mixture to the burnt pan and let it work. Light burn marks will disappear immediately. You won't even need a scrubbing brush. It will only come in handy for stronger burn marks. You can also use this mixture on various other stubborn kitchen stains on metal surfaces and aluminum pots. Just remember not to clean plastic surfaces with a mixture containing acetone.